Is the 1060 the minimum spec GPU for Star Citizen? That is today's video. Now, if you've been following this channel for a little bit, you'll know that I've been looking for a while to find the minimum spec overall system for Star Citizen. And we've been looking at a few different GPUs. And today, I think we found the actual minimum spec GPU. So I've gone and done a load of testing. I managed to buy myself one of these. Man, if I look like I've been crying, it's not because I've paid £250 on it. It's just because it's hay fever season. But it's horrible. The prices at the moment are terrible and I had to pay a crazy amount, £250, convert that into your currency. It's not good. It's really overpaying. For you guys, I've done it. I've committed. I've paid the money to get it for you. So we'll get into the testing now. It's all been done at 1080p. I've redone the testing because it's a new patch, so you can't really compare against patches. So it's all in 3.13. So all the testing is 1080p apart from the 3080, which I've always just kept in 1440p because it makes no difference. The 3080 is so quick that it makes no difference. So let's get into it. Wally's Bar, and today we're starting with the worst results and then getting better. And this isn't a great result. Wally's Bar is particularly intensive on GPUs, it seems, at the moment. So with the i5 system, it's only hitting 20 FPS. When you relieve the CPU bottleneck a bit with the 5900X system, we go up to 24 FPS. But yeah, it's not a great result. Into Lorville, and things are on the up. These results are not bad, especially for cities and especially for Lorville. 24.2 FPS average is not brilliant, but it's playable, at least on the i5 system. But when you remove the CPU bottleneck, the 1060 is able to get an average of 35.8 FPS, which is great. And if you look at the stats there on the right-hand side, the GPU load, basically, it's maxed out pretty much the whole way through. But that's a good thing. We want to see what these 1060 can actually do. So yeah, I'm pretty happy with those. Into Area 18, the Plaza here, and these are good results again. To hit 27 average FPS here on the minimum spec system with the i5, that's good. And obviously there's a bit of craziness going on there with the 1% loads, but on whole, the performance is pretty good and playable. And again, when you remove the CPU bottleneck, you actually get to see where the full potential of the 1060 is with the 5900X results. So yeah, pretty good. Quantum travel, which is a pretty tricky part of the game for GPUs. It's maxing out on both systems really, as you see there with the stats, but 30 FPS is pretty good. And over the RX 570, it's a decent improvement. And actually I'd say this is pretty playable. Calliope, which is another intensive area of the game for GPUs. And as we'll see here, it's a great improvement over the 570. And in both systems, we're GPU bound, the results are basically the same. So even on the minimum spec system, we're all on the GPU here. But yeah, 35 is great. I was quite impressed by this. It's a big, big improvement over the AMD card. Well, here is a fun result. Everest Harbor. You've got a scenario here where the 1060 is outperforming the 5900X with the 3080, which obviously doesn't make any sense. But in Star Citizen world, we know that it does make sense because even though I've made a video quite recently saying in cities, performance is mainly down to CPU single thread performance, in areas that aren't particularly bound by the render thread and things like that we talked about in that video, the server still plays a massive role in performance, and what's going on in the server makes a big difference. So my guess here is that the server that the 3080 was on was busier. But yeah, good performance all around here, whatever system you've got. So yeah, nothing to complain about. Now the test where we look just down at Arc Core from space, and it's a pretty light GPU and CPU part of the game, to be fair. And as you'll see here, the results are pretty good. You'd be very happy getting 60 or 50 FPS with the 1060. What's really going on here is that on the i5 system, the GPU is slightly bottlenecked by the CPU, as you'll see. And then when you go to the 5900X system, it just removes that slight bottleneck and it just jumps up another 10 FPS. But yeah, good results. Again, a big improvement over the RX 570. Space finally, and there's nothing really going on in space. It's quite light on the CPU and the GPU. And as you can see, good performance for everything, even the AMD card. The difference between the two systems, yes, there's a CPU bottleneck on the i5, but really 65 FPS is good. And this is a good scenario where you actually see that there is not much point going for a really high-end graphics card with Star Citizen as it currently is, at least at 1080p, because yeah, there's no difference between the 1060 and the 3080 on the 5900X system. So there we go. So what to make of all this? Well, I would say for the first time, the minimum spec system that I've built is actually playable. I didn't really struggle to play with the i5 and the 1060. It worked pretty well. That's the first time I've been able to say that. With all the other GPUs, with the i3 that we use in there, it was not good. But this was playable, and I'm pretty happy to say, in my opinion, that would be a decent minimum spec system. So if you're looking to buy something cheap, somewhere around the 1060, there's other equivalents, but somewhere around that mark is pretty good. It's not perfect by any stretch. There's definite parts where you drop under 30, there's definite parts where you drop under 25, and there's a few bits where you're in certain areas of the game where you'll drop under 20. But the game obviously is not optimized, and I think at this stage you'd accept that sort of performance. In the future, this is all going to change. Obviously, we know that CIG are working on Vulkan and the Gen 12 renderer, and that's coming. And we know that actually performance is going to change. So if you're like me and you kind of geek out over all this sort of stuff, I'm quite excited to see what's going to happen and looking forward to retesting all these parts when they actually finally manage to get that stuff in. But for today, yeah, I would say it's a decent option, the 1060. And I think actually, even though it's cost way too much money, and that is worth talking about itself, that you really, if you can avoid buying a GPU or any computer part right now, you really should avoid it. But if you had to get something to tide you over until you can get a newer part, the 1060 6GB version, I wouldn't touch the 3GB version, but the 6GB version for Star Citizen would be a nice little placeholder. But yeah, they're still silly money. And if I don't sell this before the crash, I don't know what they'll be worth when actually all these prices crash. It will drop it dramatically. But for now, I'll hold on to it and do some more testing as we go. But yes, I think that it'll do for this video. If you like this more technical look at Star Citizen, subscribe and a lovely like for this video as well. And come and follow me on Twitch, where when I get to 100,000 Twitch followers, I'm going to get a tattoo of Chris Roberts' face on my foot. See you soon. Bye.